Now let's talk about the case in which we cannot put the balancing mass in the same place as the disturbing mass. Okay, so in this case we have two sub cases when the two balancing masses can be on opposite sides of the disturbing mass. So this is the disturbing mass and you have these two balancing masses on the opposite sides. The second case could be that this is your disturbing mass and your balancing masses are on the same side of that disturbing mass. Okay, so this is the side view or the front view and this is the side view. So you can see that they all look to be in the same plane, but in actually they are in different planes. Okay, now the distance of the first balancing mass from the disturbing mass is L1 and the second balancing mass from the disturbing mass is L2. Similarly, you have L1 and then L2. Okay, and the radii of rotations for the disturbing mass is R, for the first balancing mass B1 and the second balancing mass B2. So we'll first of all look at this case, that is when the balancing masses are on the same side of the disturbing mass. So what we will do, we'll take two cases in this further. I'll take moments first about B and then about C. Okay, so due to this you will have a centrifugal force which is, I would say, capital M, okay, omega square R. Due to this you have a centrifugal force which is B1 omega square small b1. Okay, and due to this we have B2 omega square small b2. Okay, so let's first of all take the moments about point B. So sum of moments about point B should be 0. This is the first case. So I'll take this centrifugal force into the distance. So you will have capital M omega square R into L1 is equal to B2 omega square into B1 into L2. Okay, so your omega square is cancelled off and you will get M R L1 should be equal to B2 small b2 into L2. So this is what will give you the condition for balancing. So in this we are balancing the couples about a single point or a reference point. In this next case I would take moments about point C. Okay, and that would give me summation MC is equal to 0. So you will have this force into L1 plus L2, isn't it? So you will have capital M omega square R into L1 plus L2 is equal to this force into L2. So B1 omega square small b1 into L2. Okay, so your again omega square and omega square are cancelled off and the condition that you get is capital M R into L1 plus L2 is equal to B1 small b1 into L2. Okay, so you should note down these two things. No need to remember them, but just remember to find out these two moments about B and then about C, and then you will get the conditions to calculate the missing parameters. Now we'll come to this part. In this part, the balancing masses are on the opposite side of the disturbing mass. So you will have this as the centrifugal force. Okay, and this would go capital B1 omega square small b1 B2 omega square small b2. So again we will take first of all the moment about point B, isn't it? So you will have summation mb equal to 0, and this will give you b1 omega square small b1 into l1 is equal to capital B2 omega square small b2 into l2. Okay, so you can strike these off and you will have b1 small b1 l1 equal to b2 small b2 l2. This is the first condition. The second condition is to calculate the moment about point C. So you will have summation mc0, and this will give you capital B1 omega square small b1 into l1 plus l2, okay, equal to, you will have capital M omega square r into l2. Again, you can just get rid of this omega square, and the final value that you will get is capital B1 into small b1 into l1 plus l2 is equal to mr l2. So this is the condition that you get after equating the moments about point C to 0. Okay, so these two cases can be understood, okay, which is for the balancing of a rotating mass by two balancing masses, okay, that are on the different planes. Now, in the next video, we will look at the case in which the masses are there, and there are several masses which are rotating in the same plane.